Hello everyone, and welcome back to Math 220A, Mathematical Logic. Lecture 22, Saturated Models. So far, we have concentrated on models that realize as few types as possible, namely the prime and the atomic models. Today, we will study models realizing as many types as possible, modulo the cardinality restrictions. So throughout our discussion today, we assume that T is a complete theory with infinite models, in a language L, which is countable. So many of the points we'll be making can also be adapted to languages of arbitrary cardinality, but it will simplify some technical details for us today. So, first definition. Let kappa be an infinite cardinal. Then we say that M, a model of T, is kappa saturated if for every a subset of M, if the cardinality of A is strictly less than kappa, and P is an n type over M for some n, a natural number greater or equal than 1, then P is realized in M. So in other words, every n type over a set strictly smaller than kappa, of size strictly smaller than kappa, is realized in M. And as in the case of homogeneity, we say that M is saturated if it is the cardinality of M saturated. We have the following proposition showing some flexibility in this definition. Proposition 1. Assume that kappa is an infinite cardinal. Then the following are equivalent. 1, M is kappa saturated, according to the definition we just gave. 2, if A is a subset of M, with the cardinality of A strictly less than kappa, and P is a possibly incomplete n type over A, then P is realized in M. So in the definition we don't have to restrict to complete types. And 3, if A is a subset of M with the cardinality less than kappa, and P is a one type, complete one type over A, then P is realized in M. So the point is that if we can realize arbitrary one types over a small set of parameters, then we can realize n types as well for any n. Proof. 1 implies 2. Assume that M is kappa saturated and P is an incomplete type, n type, let's say, over A, so that the cardinality of A is less than kappa. Then, of course, there is a complete type P star, an n-type of array in M, such that P star extends P. So this is just by Zorn's lemma, or by taking an elementary extension and realizing the type. It's the same thing. But then, because by assumption of saturation, P star is realized in M, so is P. The implication 2 implies 3 is clear, because if you can realize any n type, even not necessarily complete, we can in particular realize all complete 1 types. So it remains to show that 3 implies 1. We prove this by induction on n. The arity of the type, the number of free variables in a type. So suppose P is a complete n-type of array, and let Q be a complete type, n minus 1 type of array. So let this be the type given by collecting all formulas of the form phi of x1 through xn minus 1. So only x1 through xn minus 1 appear as a free variable, where phi is a formula in P. We know that this is indeed a type, because it's a subtype of P. So it has to be consistent with the theory of M in the language with all the elements of the parameter set capital A named by constants. Now, by the inductive assumption, Q is realized by some n minus 1 tuple, a bar, in m to the n. Now we let R be a 1 type over A together with the parameters A1 through a n minus 1, so the realization of Q. So we'll take R to be the type given by all formulas of the form psi a bar xn, such that phi of x1 through xn belongs to P. So phi is in particular an LA formula. Note again that this is indeed a type which is complete. Both follow from the assumption that P is a complete type, and that A bar satisfies the type Q. So it's a little exercise to check that this is indeed a complete type. Now, by 3, we can realize R by some element B in M, but then of course we have that the tuple A bar B realizes P in M. Next, we observe that homogeneity is a consequence of saturation. So if M is kappa saturated, then M is also kappa homogeneous. Proof. So we assume that we're given a kappa saturated structure M. And suppose that A is a subset of M of cardinality less than kappa, and F from A to M is a partial elementary map. Let B be an element of M which is not in A. If it is in A, then there is nothing to extend, but we want to extend the partial elementary map F to a new element. So without loss of generality, it's not in A. Then we let gamma be the set of formulas of the form phi of x f of a bar, where a bar is an m-tuple from the set of parameters a for m, an arbitrary natural number, and such that m satisfies phi of b a bar. Note that if the formula phi of x f of a bar isn't gamma, then by the definition of gamma, we have that m satisfies exists x phi of x a bar, and hence, as the map f is assumed to be a partial elementary map, we also have that m satisfies exists x phi of x f of a bar, since a bar isn't the domain of f. Thus, using that gamma is closed under conjunctions, we conclude that gamma is consistent with the A theory of M, because it is finitely consistent, as we just pointed out, so it is consistent. And as M is assumed to be kappa saturated, and gamma of X is a type over the set of parameters f of a, which we know is of cardinality strictly less than kappa, because it's the image of the set A of cardinality less than kappa, it follows that M must realize it. So there is some C in M realizing gamma. Then we can take F together with the pair BC, and we see that this is a partial elementary map with B in the domain. So this shows that M is kappa homogeneous. Next, we focus on the case of countably saturated models. Note that if M is aleph not saturated, then M realizes all types in Sn of t, so all types without parameters, for all n a natural number greater or equal than 1. Because, of course, this can be viewed as types over the empty set of parameters, which is clearly has cardinality less than countable, less than aleph not. Now, we show that for the case of countably homogeneous models, this condition is also sufficient. So, for aleph not homogeneous, this condition is also sufficient. Namely, we have the following proposition 3. If M is a model of T, then M is aleph not saturated if and only if M is aleph not homogeneous and M realizes all types over the empty set. So all types is in SNT for n greater or equal than 1. Proof. The imprecation from left to right follows by proposition 2, which says that every aleph not saturated model is in particular aleph not homogeneous. And the remark we just made . Hence, our task is to show the converse implication from right to left. So let A bar be some tuple of length M from the structure M. And let P be an n-type over this tuple. So this is a slight abuse of notation. More precisely, we want to say this is the set consisting of the elements of the tuple. And let Q be an n plus m type in T, which we take to be the type consisting of the formulas phi of V bar W bar, such that phi of V bar A bar is in P. Note that this is indeed a complete type without parameters, consistent with the theory, because P was a complete type over the parameter set A bar. So this type is realized by the tuple given by the realization of P over A bar, concatenation with A bar. Okay, so given this Q over the empty set, by assumption, there is some tuple B bar C bar of length n plus m realizing Q. Since Q realizes all types of infinitely many variables over the empty set, so we can realize Q. Now, as the type of C bar is equal to the type of A bar by assumption, by the definition of Q. And we also have that M is aleph not homogeneous. It follows that there is some tuple D bar of length M such that the type of the tuple A bar D bar in M is the same as the type of the tuple C bar B bar in M. Hence, it follows that D bar realizes P by the definition of Q. And so M is aleph not saturated, because given any finite set of parameters, we could have started with the tuple A bar enumerating this set of parameters. An immediate corollary of the proposition 3 is that if M and N are two models of T, which are countable and saturated, then they have to be isomorphic So there exists at most one countable saturated model of T, apto isomorphism. Proof. By the assumption that M and N are both countable and saturated, we have that M, N are also aleph not homogeneous. By proposition 2, and they both realize all types in Sn of t for all n greater or equal than 1. Hence, we have two countable homogeneous models realizing the same set of types, namely all types is in Sn of t. Then by the uniqueness theorem for homogeneous structures, proof plus time, we conclude that M is actually isomorphic to N. So this corollary addresses the question of uniqueness of homogeneous models. But now we also have to demonstrate that they actually exist. So let M be a model of T. Then there exists N, an elementary extension of M, such that N is aleph not homogeneous. And the cardinality of N is equal to the cardinality of M. Recall that we're assuming throughout our discussion today is that T is a complete theory with infinite models. Proof. We first show that we can find some elementary extension N1 of M such that the cardinality of N1 is the same as the cardinality of M, and such that if A bar, B bar, C are all in M, where A bar and B bar are tuples of elements of finite length, and the type of A bar in M is equal to the type of B bar in M, then there is an element D in N1 such that the type in N1 of A bar C is equal to the type in N1 of B bar D. So we can extend the partial elementary map at the price of passing to an elementary extension, but without increasing the cardinality. So to demonstrate that this is possible, we let a sequence A bar alpha, B bar alpha, C alpha, for alpha smaller than the cardinality of M, list all tuples A bar, B bar, C, where we have that A bar, B bar, C are in M, and such that the type of A bar in M is equal to the type of B bar. Okay, so the total number of such tuples is the same as the cardinality of the structure M, because it's infinite. So it's possible to choose such an enumeration. Next, we build an elementary chain M0, an elementary extension of 1 of M0, etc. So we have M alpha, etc. For alpha strictly less than the cardinality of M, with some additional properties that we will explain in the process of the construction. So we let M0 be the original structure M, if alpha is a limit ordinal, we let M alpha be the union of the elementary chain of the models M beta for beta less than alpha, which is hence an elementary extension of all of these M betas. Now, given M alpha, so we're dealing with the successor step now, so given M alpha, we let M alpha plus 1 be an elementary extension of M alpha, such that the cardinality of M alpha is equal to the cardinality of M alpha plus 1, and such that there exists some element D in this new structure M alpha plus 1, such that the type in M alpha plus 1 of the tuple A bar alpha C alpha is equal to the type in M alpha plus 1 of the tuple B alpha together with this new element D. So note that this is always possible because we can consider the type P of X given by the type of C alpha in M alpha over the tuple A bar alpha. So this is a type which we know is always possible to realize in some elementary extension of the structure M alpha containing the parameters. And of course we can ensure that this structure realizing this new type has the same cardinality, because we just need to add a single element, and then we can take by Löwenheim's column the elementary substructure containing this new single element D realizing the type in the bigger structure M alpha plus 1. Okay, so this tells us that it's always possible to ensure this condition. And finally, we let N1 be the union overall alpha less than the cardinality of M of M alpha. Now note that N1 is a union of at most cardinality of M many models, each of size at most the cardinality of M. So we have that the cardinality of N1 is less or equal than M times the cardinality of M, and M is infinite. So, of course, this is just the cardinality of N. And N1 is an elementary extension of M as a union of an elementary chain, of a chain of elementary extensions. And it satisfies the required condition that we started with for each tuple. Because every tuple appears as A alpha, B alpha, C alpha for some alpha, and hence we found the corresponding D realizing it in N1. Of course, now in N1 we have more tuples which we have to treat in order to ensure homogeneity. This can be achieved by iterating this construction. So we now build an elementary chain N0, elementary extension N1 of N0, N2 of N1, etc. A countable elementary chain such that the cardinality of Ni is the same as the cardinality of M, and if A bar, B bar, C are all in Ni, and the type in Ni of A bar is the same as the type in Ni of B bar, then there is D in Ni plus 1 such that the type in Ni plus 1 of A bar C is the same as the type of B bar D. Now, this chain can be built iterating the previous claim. So first we found n0. First we found n1 by applying the claim to the original structure M. Now we can apply the claim to this newly found structure N1 to obtain N2, etc. On each step, this condition is satisfied. And so what remains is to take N to be the union of this elementary chain of Ni for I less than omega. Then again, we have that the cardinality of N is the same, well, it's less or equal than aleph node times the cardinality of each of the Ni's, but they all have the same cardinality as M. So this is equal to the cardinality of M. And by construction, N is aleph node homogeneous. And of course, N is also an elementary extension of M, because N1 was an elementary extension of M. So this concludes the proof of the proposition. Combining our results discussed so far, we can now characterize theories which admit countable saturated models. So namely, we have the following theorem. T, which recall is a complete theory in a countable language with infinite models. So T has a countable saturated model if and only if the cardinality of the space of types of T as N is countable for all n greater or equal than 1. Proof. Left to right. So suppose that T has a countable saturated model. Then, in particular, every n type is realized in M, but the number of n tuples in M is of course also at most countable, since the model M itself is countable. So this implies that the number of all types is also countable, because each of them is realized in M, and there are only countable many possible tuples in M, which we can use to realize these types. And the same tuple, of course, cannot realize two different types. So this implication is straightforward. Let us show the converse. So suppose that the cardinality of Sn of t is less or equal than aleph node for all n greater or equal than 1. We will show that then t has a countable saturated model. So let us list all the types. So let P0, P1, etc. list all elements of the union over all n natural numbers greater or equal than 1 Sn of t. So again, this is a countable set, a countable union of countably many sets, hence itself countable. And let us take M0, an arbitrary countable model realizing t. Of course, it exists by Löwenheim's column, because the theory T is in a countable language throughout our discussion today. Now, we know that any n-type over an arbitrary structure M can be realized in some n, an elementary extension of M with n the same cardinality, just using the compactness theorem and the downwards Löwenheim's column theorem. Now, iterating this fact, we can build an elementary chain M0, M1, etc., such that each MI is countable and such that MI plus 1 realizes the type PI. Then we can take M to be the union of this elementary chain. And what we get is a countable elementary extension of M0. So in particular, a model of T such that M contains realizations of all types in Sn of t, so types without parameters, for all n less than omega. Moreover, by the previous proposition, by proposition 4, there exists n, an elementary extension of M, such that it has the same cardinality, and such that N is aleph not homogeneous. In particular, we still have, by the choice of M, since every P in Sn of t was realized in M, and N is an elementary extension, it is also realized in N. So every N type is realized in N, and so we have obtained an aleph not homogeneous countable model, because M was countable, which realizes all of the types without parameters, is in Sn of t for all N. Hence, by our corollary that we just proved, it follows that N is also aleph not saturated and countable. So we have obtained N saturated model. Curiously, existence of large models, saturated models, also implies existence of small models, prime ones. Before showing that, we need an important dichotomy result about the possible numbers of types theorem. So assume, as always, T is a complete theory in a countable language. Let M be a model of T, A subset of M countable. And assume that the number of n types over A is strictly less than 2 to the aleph not for some n, then we also get that in fact it is countable, at most countable. So the size of the space of types is less or equal than aleph not. Proof. Suppose that we have more than countably many types over A, a countable set of parameters. Our task is to show that then there are continuum many different types. As there are only countably many LA formulas in with n three variables, there has to exist some single formula phi in LA such that the cardinality of the base set, so all types containing phi, is also not countable. Now we have the following claim. if the cardinality of the set of types containing phi is uncountable, then there is some formula psi with parameters in A such that the cardinality of the set of types containing phi and psi is uncountable, and also the cardinality of the set of types containing phi and the negation of psi is uncountable. So it's possible to split our basic set into two basic sets, each uncountable. Suppose not, and let us define the set of formulas P consisting of all formulas of the form psi of x bar such that the cardinality of the set of types containing phi and psi is uncountable. Note that for each psi in LA, we have that either psi is in P or the negation of psi is in P, but not both. So this is just by the assumption that we cannot split the set corresponding to phi into two sets with uncountably many types in them. So we show that P is in fact satisfiable towards this purpose. Suppose we have psi 1 through psi m, finitely many formulas from P, then we have that either psi 1 conjunction psi m is in P, in which case we also have that the union of all these formulas, psi 1, psi m, together with the A theory of M is satisfiable. That's because any formula belonging to P belongs to at least one type. In fact, it belongs to many. And that type is consistent with the theory, the A theory of M. So we have either this, or we have that not psi 1 disjunction with not psi m belongs to P. So this is by the previous remark that either P or not P, psi or not psi has to belong to P. Okay, so we have this, but because the base set corresponding to the negations, disjunction of the negations of the formulas psi m is in fact just the union of the sets corresponding to these formulas, we must have in this case that the cardinality of not psi I, so the set of types which contain it, is uncountable for some I between 1 and m. But this is a contradiction, because then we would have that both psi I and the negation of psi I belong to P, and we already remarked that this is impossible by our assumption. So we get a contradiction, thus it follows that P is in fact a complete type over A. Moreover, if psi is not in P, then we must have that the cardinality of the set of types containing phi and psi is less or equal than null if not countable. But also we have that the set of types containing phi is equal to the union over all psi not in P, conjunction phi and psi together with the set consisting of the single element P. But writing it like this implies, since there are only finitely many countably many formulas psi, This implies that the set square brackets phi is the union of at most countably many sets, each of size at most aleph node. Because as we just remarked, any formula psi not np, the corresponding set has cardinality at most aleph node. So this would imply that the set of types containing phi is itself at most countable, but this is a contradiction. Hence, we have proved the claim. Now we use the claim to build a binary tree of formulas phi sigma, for sigma a finite sequence of zeros and ones, such that, one, if sigma, if tau extends sigma, then we have that the formula phi tau implies phi sigma. Two, phi sigma with I added, 0 or 1, added at the end of the sequence, implies the negation of phi sigma together with 1 minus I. So if it was one, I was 1, this is 0, and vice versa. And three, the cardinality of the Clopen set phi sigma is uncountable for every sigma. So how to do it? We start with f empty set, which we take to be phi, for some phi, such that the cardinality of the set of types containing phi is uncountable, which we're assuming exists, and given phi sigma, such that the cardinality of the corresponding set is uncountable. By the claim, we know that we can find some psi in LA such that the cardinality of the set phi sigma and psi is uncountable, and the cardinality of the set phi sigma and the negation of psi is uncountable. In this case, we let phi sigma together with zero to be phi sigma and psi, and we let phi sigma 1 to be phi sigma conjunction with the negation of psi. Now it follows that for each f, an infinite sequence of zeros and ones, there is some pf belonging to the intersection of the sets phi f restricted to the first m symbols over all m from 0 to infinity, and such that pf is a complete type over A, and such that if f is not equal to g, then pf is not equal to pg. Thus we conclude that we have built continuum many types corresponding to all possible paths through the infinite binary tree, and so we have that this is at least 2 to the aleph node. Let us stop today with the proof of this nice dichotomy for the possible number of types over a countable set. And next time we'll see how this can be used to further clarify the connection between the existence of saturated and prime models and some other applications. Thank you very much for your attention.